Hello, this short presentation is about physics exam technique and in particular how important are calculation questions in exams and how should you approach them to get the best marks? Well, I did some analysis of the 2016 VCE physics exam, which is a post-16 qualification here in Australia. The first four questions were all calculate, all said calculate in them, and they were all worth a number of marks. So I added up the number of marks of the whole paper that said calculate and looked at some other question types and found that 50% of the questions were calculate. About 3% said recall or give a fact. 10% were asking to draw or annotate or plot a graph. 8% were asking to interpret some data given in the question, and that left nearly a third of the paper, a little less than a third of the paper, where you're asking to explain or discuss a concept. So calculations are clearly really important in this post-16 qualification, and my experience of A-level, IB, international GCSEs, it's no different. The breakdown is about the same. So how should you approach calculation questions? Well, let's just look at one very simple example, and I'll show you how I would approach it. A red laser beam has a wavelength of 621 nanometers. Determine the frequency of light. So this calculation you might see in an A-level or IB or VCE paper. Step one is data. Gather all of the appropriate data together and summarize it. Now, I would do this in an exam or when doing an exercise. I'd write down the symbols. Lambda is the wavelength. That's what's given here. C is the speed of light. This data would be given on the data sheet or at the beginning of the exam paper, not with the question. And I'm after the frequency. So I've written down the three symbols I'm after and the data that I know. Step two is the equation. Find the appropriate equation from a data sheet, or sometimes for some courses you need to know them. Here I need speed. Wave speed is frequency times wavelength. Step three is standard units. You have to convert units before calculation, often into standard units. So here, lambda is 621 nanometers. I would look up the conversion factor, which on VCE is on the data sheet, and convert nano, meaning times 10 to the minus 9. And I'd write that out. The easiest way is just to keep the numbers exactly the same. And where I had n, I replace with times 10 to the minus 9, and meters still stays. Step four, the workings. Rearrange the algebra first and then substitute the numbers in. So I wouldn't put numbers in here, but I would rearrange the equation to make f the subject, speed over wavelength. If you've got more complicated algebra, then it really does pay to rearrange the letters first before you put in the numbers. Then you put in the numbers, and I'd write them out on my workings as I put in like this. Step five is the answer. Calculate the answer and give it to an appropriate number of significant figures. So three significant figures here is appropriate because I have three significant figures in the data. And step six is units. Quote the correct standard unit. Hertz here is the unit for frequency, which again you need to know. I ask my students to underline the answer. So I hope that helps to summarize the steps needed in calculation questions. DESWAU. Not a very memorable mnemonic, but maybe it will help you just to get your process right, which will help you to make fewer mistakes. Bye.